Good morning, students. In this class, I will discuss about Laplacian operator. It is denoted with del square. The scalar differential operator del square defined as dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square is known as Laplacian operator. Since del square can be written as del dot del, dot product between gradient operator or vector differential operator. Del means I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z, dot product with same vector. So we will have I dot I1, j dot j1, k dot k1, and dot product between these two vectors is dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. So it is the value of del square. So here del square is known as Laplacian operator. Now applying phi to del square, that is del square phi, can be written as a div of grad phi. Both are same because del square phi means del dot del phi, but del phi means grad phi. Del dot means divergence. So divergence of grad phi is dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square of phi. So del square phi can be written as div of grad phi. Both are same. Now important result on del square. Del square of f of r is f double dash of r plus 2 by r into f dash of r. Using this condition, we can find del square for functions of r. So to prove this, consider left hand side del square of f of r. But del square can be written as del dot del. So del of f of r, in previous class we have seen the gradient of function of r, that is f dash of r into r bar by r. So replacing this value, but del dot means sigma I dot dou by dou x of f dash of r into r bar by r. Now here we will have three functions, that is f dash of r, r bar and 1 by r. So here we have to apply product rule. Product rule for three functions u, v, w. So f dash of r into r bar kept as silent, 1 by r derivative is minus 1 by r square into dou r by dou x, plus f dash of r by r is kept as silent and r bar derivative with respect to x is dou by dou x of r bar, xi derivative is I bar, yj and zk derivative becomes 0. So I bar. Next, r bar by r is kept as silent, f dash of r derivative with respect to x is f double dash of r, and then we have to take the derivative of r with respect to x, but we will have dou r upon dou x is x by r. So replacing this, x by r. Now simplifying this, that means rearranging the terms. Now operating with I dot, I dot is operated with r bar because a vector is operated with another vector, like I dot r bar. I dot r bar is x, because I dot xi plus yj plus zk, I only means not only I, so I having 0j plus 0k, so dot producting we will get x. Already we have x here, x into x is x square. I dot I, but what is I dot I? 1. For last term, I dot r bar, I dot r bar again we will have x. Already we have x, x into x is x square. So applying summation, sigma x square. Sigma x square means x square plus y square plus z square is r square. So replacing this, r square r square, r square r square get cancelled. Now rearranging the terms, first writing f double dash of r, we have 3 by r f dash of r minus 1 by r f dash of r, but 3 by r f dash of r minus 1 by r f dash of r is 2 by r into f dash of r. So this is the right hand side. problem on Laplacian operator. Prove that del square of 1 by r is 0, del square of log r is 1 by r square, del square of r power n is n into n plus 1 r power n minus 2. To prove these statements, first we have to know about Laplacian operator for function of r, that is del square of f of r. But del square of f of r is f double dash of r plus 2 by r into f dash of r. Using this equation, we can prove these three conditions. For this, first we have to define function of r and we have to compute two derivatives, that is first order derivative and second order derivative. Consider first sum. So here we will define function of r, that is f of r, as 1 by r. Now whose successive derivatives, that is the first order derivative is f dash of r, 1 by r derivative is minus 1 by r square. Now second order derivative f double dash of r, again differentiating minus 1 by r square, minus constant 1 by r square derivative minus 2 by r cube, minus into minus plus, so that 2 by r cube is f double dash of r. Now substituting these values in equation 1, that is del square of f of r is replaced with 1 by r, f double dash of r is 2 by r cube plus 2 by r into f dash of r, which is replaced with minus 1 by r square. Now simplifying this, plus into minus minus, 2 by r cube, 2 by r cube get cancelled, 0. So thus we will have del square of 1 by r is 0. The first statement is proved. Now coming to second one, that is del square of log r is 1 by r square. For this, define f of r as log r. The log r successive derivatives are f dash of r is 1 by r and f double dash of r, again differentiating 1 by r, we will get minus 1 by r square. Now again substituting these values in equation 1. So equation 1 is del square of f of r is f double dash of r plus 2 by r into f dash of r. So replacing f dash of r and f double dash of r values. Now simplifying this, 2 by r into 1 by r is 2 by r square minus 1 by r square. Subtracting, we will get 1 by r square. So it is the value of del square of log r. So del square of log r is 1 by r square. Now last one, f of r is r power n, whose successive derivative is f dash of r. F dash of r is n into r power n minus 1. Now again differentiating with respect to r, we will get f double dash of r. So n silent, r power n minus 1 derivative. But what is r power n minus 1 derivative? N minus 1 into r power n minus 1 minus 1. N minus 1 minus 1 is n minus 2. Because d by dx of x power n is n into x power n minus 1. Now substituting these values in equation 1. So equation 1 is del square of r is f double dash of r plus 2 by r into f dash of r. So replacing these, r power n minus 1 whole by r. So that is r power n minus 2. Because the denominator r, if it comes to on numerator, it will be r power minus 1. We will have r power n minus 1. Thus, r power n minus 1 minus 1 is r power n minus 2. Now, taking out r power n minus 2 as common, so that is n into n is n square. N into minus 1 is minus n plus 2n. 2n minus n, but 2n minus n is n. N plus n square into r power n minus 2. Now taking out n from these two, that is n into n plus 1, r power n minus 2. It is the value of del square of r power n. So prove these statements, we have to know about this formula. Formula is del square of f of r equal to f double dash of r plus 2 by r into f dash of r. So to find del square for functions of r, we have to remember these formula. This formula is very important to find the del square for function of r. another problem on Laplacian operator. That is, prove that divergence of grad of r power m is m into m plus 1 r power m minus 2. This problem can also be given as prove that del square of r power m is m into m plus 1 into r power m minus 2. First of all, we have to know about these two, left hand side. Div of grad of r power m and del square of r power m, both are same, not different, because del square of r power m can be written as del dot del of r power m. Del of r power m means grad of r power m, and del dot dot means dot product means we have to use divergence. So that is a divergence of grad of r power m. Suppose there is a del cross, then it will be curl of, but here we will have dot product, so that we have to use divergence. So divergence of grad of r power m, both are same. Del square is a del dot del of r power m. Del of r power m is grad of r power m. Del dot means divergence. Now to prove this equation, first of all, we have to know about the basics, that is, r bar is a position vector about the point P of xyz. The position vector about the origin to the point P of xyz is OP bar. OP bar is r bar. R bar is xi plus yj plus zk, and r is the magnitude of r bar, that is root of x square plus y square plus z square. So here r bar is vector and r is scalar. There is a lot of difference between r bar and r. R bar is a vector and r is whose magnitude, that is a scalar, which does not contains any ijks. Now squaring on both sides this scalar, we will have r square is x square plus y square plus z square, and differentiating partially with respect to x, y, z respectively, we will have dou r upon dou x is x by r, dou r upon dou y is y by r, dou r upon dou z is z by r. These values are quietly difference between dou r bar by dou x is I bar, dou r bar by dou y is j bar, dou r bar by dou z is k bar. There is a lot of difference between dou r bar by dou x and dou r by dou x. So first of all, we have to remember these values until the last concept is completed according to vector calculus. These are very, very, very important formulas related to the position vector r bar. Now, to prove this statement, consider grad of r power m. Grad means del. Del of r power m means sigma I dou by dou x of r power m. Now, differentiating r power m partially with respect to x, whose derivative is m into r power m minus 1, and then we have to write dou r by dou x, but dou r by dou x is x by r. Now r power m minus 1 by r is r power m minus 2 into x. Now consider div of grad of r power m. So just applying div to the obtained grad of r power m. Div means del dot, so that is del dot del of r power m. But what is mean by del dot del? Del square. So that del square of r power m and div of grad of r power m, both are same, not different. Now del dot means sigma I dot dou by dou x. Now just we have obtained a result, that is grad of r power m. Replacing this, now taking out m as common because m is constant. Now I dot I, but what is the value of I dot I? 1. So I dot I is 1. Now differentiating partially with respect to x to the function r power m minus 2 into x using product rule. So x is keep it as a silent, r power m minus 2 derivative is m minus 2 into r power m minus 3 plus r power m minus 2, keep it as a silent, x derivative is 1. Now operating with the summation x square is r square. Summation 1 means 3. Now simplifying this, taking out r power m minus 2 from these two, m minus 2 plus 3 is m plus 1. So it is the required value of Good morning, students. Here we will discuss about vector identities. To prove vector identities, just we have to know about the basic formulas. That is, a bar dot b bar is b bar dot a bar. It is known as commutative law or abelian law. In cross products, a bar cross b bar is equal to negative b bar cross a bar. A bar dot b bar cross c bar is a bar cross b bar dot c bar. A bar dot b bar cross c bar, here just interchanging dot and cross product, b bar cross c bar can be written as minus c bar cross b bar, and using first one, so thus the equation becomes negative of a bar cross c bar dot b bar. These statements are known as distributive law. A bar cross b bar cross c bar is a bar dot c bar into b bar minus a bar dot b bar into c bar. To remember this, we have 1 into 2 into 3 is 1 into 3 into 2 minus 1 into 2 into 3. Only for remembrance, 1 into 2 into 3 is 1, 3, 2 minus 1, 2, 3. Dou by dou x of a bar dot b bar is a bar dot dou b bar by dou x plus b bar dot dou a bar by dou x. Dou upon dou x, a bar cross b bar is dou a bar by dou x cross b bar plus a bar cross dou b bar by dou x. These are the product rule for the partial derivatives of dot product between two vectors and cross product between two vectors. Now, div f bar is 0, then f bar is known as solenoidal vector. Suppose curl of f bar is 0 bar, then we have f bar is irrotational vector. Del of del dot del cross. Del of fg is f del g plus g del f. Del dot f g bar, f scalar, g is vector. That means del f dot g bar plus f into del dot g bar. Del cross f into g bar, f scalar, g vector. Applying cross product, del f cross g bar plus f into f kept silent, del cross g bar. These three are obtained by using product rule for the vector differential operator del. Now we will have operators. Del cross, del is I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z. It is known as vector differential operator. Suppose phi is any scalar potential function, we have del phi is grad phi. Grad phi means I dou phi by dou x plus j dou phi by dou y plus k dou phi by dou z. Sigma notation is sigma I dou phi by dou x. F bar is any vector point function, then div f bar is a del dot f bar. Del dot f bar means sigma I dot dou f bar by dou x. Curl f bar. Curl f bar means del cross f bar. Taking cross product, we will get sigma I bar cross dou f bar by dou x. Del phi, del dot f bar, del cross f bar. Summation notations. A bar dot del. What is mean by del? I dou by dou x plus j bar dou by dou y plus k bar dou by dou z. Taking dot product to each vector. A bar dot del of phi. Just operating phi with phi. Phi is scalar. Now operating with vector, that is f bar, same thing, just operating with f bar. Now dot is replaced with cross, so you will get the same as above statements. The Laplacian operator is del square. Del square means dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. But del square phi is nothing but div of grad phi, because div of grad phi, div means del dot, grad phi means del phi. Del dot del phi. Del dot means sigma I dot double. Good morning, students. Here we will see vector identities. The first identity is prove that curl of grad phi is a zero bar. In vector notation, this can be written as del cross del phi is zero bar, because grad phi means del phi, curl means del cross. The problem is also given as prove that grad phi is always irrotational. Because whenever curl f bar is a zero bar, then f bar is called irrotational. So grad phi is always irrotational. Proof. Let phi be any scalar point function. Now, first of all, we will find grad phi. Grad phi means I dou phi by dou x plus j dou phi by dou y plus k bar dou phi by dou z. Now, operating with curl of grad phi. Curl means we have to compute determinant. The first two rows are as usual, I bar, j bar, k bar, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. Third row is ij k quotient in grad phi, dou phi by dou x, dou phi by dou y, dou phi by dou z. Computing determinant for 3 by 3 matrices. I bar contained row column is deleted. Submatrix 2 by 2 matrix determinant A, B, C, D, whose determinant is AD minus BC. Dou by dou y of dou phi by dou z is a dou square phi by dou by dou z minus dou by dou z of dou phi by dou y is a dou square phi by dou z dou y. Similarly, for next two terms, the cofactors are plus minus plus. J bar contained row column deleted, whose submatrix determinant plus K bar contained row column deleted, whose submatrix determinant. Dou by dou x of dou phi by dou y is dou square phi by dou x dou y negative dou by dou y of dou phi by dou x is dou square phi by dou y dou x. So here all terms are get cancelled, because in second order partial derivatives the commutative law holds good. AB equal to BA, that means dou square phi by dou y dou z is equal to dou square phi by dou z dou phi dou y. Since both are similar, so these terms are get cancelled. So we will have 0i minus 0j plus 0k. It is nothing but a null vector, that is a zero bar. So curl of grad phi is a zero bar. By the definition of irrotational vector, grad phi is always irrotational. Now another identity, div of curl f bar is a zero. Div means del dot del cross f bar, because curl f bar means del cross f bar is 0. So it is vector notation. Div of curl f bar is 0, or del dot del cross f bar is 0. Or simply prove that curl f bar is solenoidal, because the definition of solenoidal is div of f bar is 0, then f bar is called solenoidal vector. So here also curl f bar is solenoidal. For this, define f bar. F bar is f1i plus f2j plus f3k is a vector point function. Now computing curl f bar. Curl f bar means del cross f bar. Determinant, as usual, first two rows are common. Ijk's, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. Third row is ijk quotients of f bar, f1, f2, f3. Now computing the determinant, similarly as above. Now consider div of curl f bar, just operating div to the obtained curl f bar. So we will have del dot del cross f bar is the vector notation. Now dot product between del and del cross f bar. Del means I dou by dou x plus j dou by dou y plus k dou by dou z. Dot product with this vector, but we know I dot I1, j dot j1, k dot k1. So taking dot product, dou by dou x of this expression minus dou by dou y of this expression plus dou by dou z of this expression. The formula is dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z. These are f1, f2, f3s. Since in second order partial derivatives commutative law holds good, so all terms are get cancelled. So we will have 0. Thus div of curl f bar is a 0. Curl f bar is a solenoidal vector. prove that del cross f bar is a del of del dot f bar minus del square f bar. Or this can be given as prove that curl of curl f bar is grad of div f bar minus del square of f bar. For this, consider left hand side. So here the left hand side is a del cross f bar. But what is the value of del cross f bar? So del cross f bar is curl f bar I j case dou by dou x dou by dou y dou by dou z. The last two is f1 f2 f3 I j k quotients of f bar. So this will be the value of curl f bar. These are I j case where f1 f2 f3. Now I j case first row dou by dou x dou by dou y dou by dou z replacing f1 f2 f3 from this identities. So f1 f2 f3, so which are to be replaced. Now computing determinant. So determinant means summation of I bar into I bar contained row column deleted. The determinant for submatrix, that is ABCD determinant, is AD minus BC. Next two terms are not written because here we are taking sigma notation. Sigma is the sum of three terms. Now sigma I bar operating with dou by dou y, dou square f2 by dou by dou x minus dou square f1 by dou y square minus dou by dou z of dou f1 by dou z is dou square f1 by dou z square minus into minus plus dou square f3 by dou z dou x. Now grouping the terms, here these first and last terms are grouped and taking minus as common in second and third terms. Now here we will add one term and subtracting the same term, that is dou by dou x of dou f1 by dou x. It is nothing but dou square f1 by dou x square, which is to be added, and minus of dou square f1 by dou x square. Both are get cancelled. We will have same expression. For our convenience, we have written like this. But what is dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z? It is nothing but div f bar. That means del dot f bar. So taking sigma notation, sigma I bar dou by dou x of del dot f bar. Dou f dou square f1 by dou x square plus dou square f1 by dou y square plus dou square f1 by dou z square. Here taking the common as f1, the expression is known as Laplacian operator, that is a del square. Sigma f1i, but what is a sigma f1i? F1i plus f2j plus f3k, it is nothing but the given vector, that is f bar. So it is the proof, that is a del cross f bar is del of del dot f bar. Del of means sigma I dou by dou x, vector differential operator del. So del of del dot f bar minus del square f bar. Now another proof, del of del dot f bar is del cross f bar plus del square f bar. For this, first we have to prove the above, that is del cross f bar as shown del of del dot f bar minus del square f bar. Now consider del of del dot f bar. This negative del square f bar taking to the left hand side, thus it will becomes positive del square f bar. Whenever the problem is given in main exams, we have to write the proof of the above identity. So this can be written as grad of div f bar is del cross means curl, del cross f bar means curl f bar plus del square f bar. Hence prove that div of a bar cross b bar is b bar curl a bar minus a bar curl b bar. This can be written in the vector notation as div means del dot a bar cross b bar is b bar curl a bar means del cross a bar minus a bar curl b bar means del cross b bar. Consider here left hand side, that is a div of a bar cross b bar. Now div means del dot, del dot means sigma I dot dou by dou x. Given expression is A bar cross B bar using the divergence definition, sigma I dot dou by dou x. But dou by dou x of A bar cross B bar can be expanded using product rule, that is dou A bar by dou x cross B bar plus A bar kept silent, dou by dou x is applied to A bar, that is A bar cross dou B bar by dou x. Now operating with the sigma I dot to each term. Now it is look like A bar dot B bar cross C bar. So we have a identity, that is A bar dot B bar cross C bar is A bar cross B bar dot C bar. So A bar is I bar here, B bar is dou A bar by dou x, C bar is B bar. So using first identity, expanding first term. Using second identity, expanding second term. That is A bar dot B bar cross C bar is negative A bar cross C bar dot B bar, because B bar cross C bar can be written as negative C bar cross B bar. Now using first one, we will have like this, that is a minus of A bar cross C bar dot B bar. Same expanding the second term. Now sigma I cross dou by dou x is del cross B bar dot A bar. Don't forget to write here negative sign, because in cross products, if we interchange the two vectors, we have to write negative sign. So this will be the value of div of A bar cross B bar. Thus identity is proved. Now curl of A bar cross B bar, we have to consider left hand side of this identity, that is a curl of A bar cross B bar. But curl means del cross. Del cross means sigma I cross dou by dou x. Given expression is A bar cross B bar. Expanding dou by dou x of A bar cross B bar using product rule in partial derivatives for the cross product between two vectors. Now operating with the sigma I cross to each term, it is look like A bar cross B bar cross C bar. But we will have A bar cross B bar cross C bar is A bar dot C bar into B bar minus A bar dot B bar into C bar. To remember this formula, we have a hint, that is 1 into 2 into 3 is equal to 1 3 2 minus 1 2 3. Once again, 1 3 2 minus 1 2 3. So using this condition, expanding the above two terms, operating sigma to each term, sigma can be applied to sigma I dou by dou x, but sigma I dou by dou x is a vector differential operator del. Del is to be used in each term. Sigma I dou by dou x is del B bar dot del into A bar. Now B bar dot del can be written as del dot B bar whole of A bar. Similarly writing next terms also, remaining terms also written as the same as the first term. So this will give the value of curl of A bar cross B bar is A bar div B bar minus B bar div A bar plus B bar dot del into A bar minus A bar dot del into B bar. Thank you. Prove that grad of A bar dot B bar is B bar dot del of A bar plus A bar dot del of B bar plus B bar cross curl A bar plus A bar cross curl B bar. To prove this identity, first we will consider A bar cross curl B bar. But curl B bar means, by the definition of curl of a vector, sigma I cross dou B bar by dou x. Now taking sigma as common, A bar cross I bar cross dou B bar by dou x. Now this will look like A bar cross B bar cross C bar. So we have identity, that is A bar dot C bar into B bar minus A bar dot B bar into C bar. For any three vectors, we have a identity. To remember this, we have 1, 2, 3 is equal to 1, 3, 2 minus 1, 2, 3. To remember us, only for to remember. Now operating same as using this identity, operating with the sigma to each term, but sigma I dou B bar by dou x is a del, that is A bar dot del of B bar. sigma I of A bar dot dou B bar by dou X. Now this will be the value of A bar cross curl B bar. Now we can write similarly B bar cross curl A bar just by replacing A by B and B by A. So we will get another equation. Now adding these two equations, adding left hand side and right hand sides. Now taking sigma as common in first and last third term, that is a sigma of I of A bar dot dou B bar by dou X plus B bar dot dou A bar by dou X. Now taking these negative to the left hand side, these will becomes positives. Now we will have A bar dot dou B bar by dou X plus B bar dot dou A bar by dou X. It is nothing but dou by dou X of A bar dot B bar. But we will have sigma I bar dou by dou X is a del. So del of A bar dot B bar. But del means grad of A bar dot B bar. This proves the required identity, that is grad of A bar dot B bar is A bar cross curl B bar plus B bar cross curl A bar plus A bar dot del of B bar plus B bar dot del of A bar. Hence proved. Now another identity, if f and g are two scalar point functions, then we have div of f del g is f del square g plus del f dot del g. So here f g are two scalar point functions. First we will consider del g, and then we have to multiply with the f, and then taking the divergence. This will respectively gives the required proof. So del g is I dou g by dou x plus j dou g by dou y plus k dou g by dou z. Now multiplying with f to each term of del g. Now taking divergence of f del g. Divergence means del dot f del g. So we have a divergence formula, that is div of f bar is dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z. So f del g ijk quotients are f1, f2 and f3. So taking dot product between del and f del g, we will have dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z. These are f1, f2, f3. So replacing these and operating dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. So we will get like this. And f is taking out common in these terms. These terms can be written as the product of two vectors, that is I bar dou f by dou x plus j bar dou f by dou y plus k bar dou f by dou z dot product with I bar dou z by dou x plus j bar dou g by dou y plus k bar dou g by dou z. But here we will have g is taking common, and the Laplacian operator is a del square, that is a dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. So that is f del square g, and this will be del f dot del g. So thus we have div of f del g is f del square g plus del f dot del g. It's proved.